5 things you can do right now that will make you love doing NoFap instead of hate it. I started to notice a pattern where there are some people that do NoFap and they just love it. It's easy for them. They're like, yeah, NoFap. It makes you feel great. I feel great. You should try it as well. And at the same time, there are also other people that really struggle to do NoFap. They're like, well, I don't feel great yet. This is really hard. You know, they kind of know that they want to do NoFap, but they can't really find the motivation. And they just suffer. They think NoFap is suffering for the long term, like suffering for the greater good. Now, I haven't just noticed this pattern from person to person, but this pattern also tends to vary in the individual. I have had phases in my NoFap journey where things seemed easy. I was incredibly hyped to do NoFap, made me feel great, and I was like, yeah, this is great, makes me feel better than when I do fap, so why the hell would I fap? But then at other phases, it's like I lost that hype. You know, I still wanted to do NoFap because I knew that fapping too much isn't that great for you. But it was hard, man. It was, I was tempted to do it all the time, and I was like, why is this stuff so hard? And so I spent a lot of time thinking about what exactly are these factors that determine, like, the difference in these two mindsets? Because this makes all the difference. Having either this negative, struggling mindset or this positive, feeling great mindset makes all the difference in, like, whether you are going to stick to NoFap in the long term. It makes the difference between whether you are going to feel miserable or whether you feel great doing NoFap. So I spent a lot of time thinking, and I did come up with a couple of things. Now, there's definitely more to it. One thing that is extremely important, for example, is to have purpose. I've said this before in previous videos, but you need to have a purpose. You need to have, like, goals in life, because you need to have that something to work towards, else NoFap as like a self-improvement tool is just gonna feel empty. Why would you improve yourself if there is no real reason to improve yourself? And so you need to have purpose, but I'm not gonna talk about that because I've talked about that in previous videos, and also that's not really something you can do right now, right? If you don't really know what your purpose is in life, then you probably can't snip your fingers and then know what your purpose is by the end of this video. So I'm not gonna go into depth about that. What I am gonna talk about right here is 5 things you can do right now that will make NoFap a lot easier, that will make you love doing NoFap instead of hating to do NoFap. Number 1, spend time with other men. I've always found that when I spend time with my friends, it's just easier to want to be a man, to like want to be a better man for some reason. And it's easier to like control your urges. Well, first of all, there's the fact that you can't really do anything with your urges when you are with your friends, obviously. But there's also something else. It's more like a feeling. Maybe it's this like evolutionary competition instinct, or maybe it's like being inspired by other men. But whenever I'm around other men, you know, even when I get an urge, because you can still see an attractive woman or have certain fantasies or whatever, but even when you get the urge, it's not just the fact that you can't actually physically do something with it, but it's also like a mindset change. There's something that changes inside of me where I am more likely to just want to be the best version of myself, to just want to act like a good man in life. Now, I think this can work especially well when you get inspired by men that are like a role model to you. So maybe these are men that are slightly older than you. Maybe these are men that are slightly more financially successful than you, have a better body than you, etc. And what I think is very important to know here is that you don't necessarily need to spend time in real life with these men, but you can also spend time digitally, like watching a YouTube video. And this is probably, I'm guessing, that this is because our brain never really evolved to like know what a computer screen is, and so it has trouble differentiating between watching someone on a computer screen or spending time with someone in real life. And so I always find that the same thing really works when I watch YouTube videos. When I watch a YouTube video of a guy, like a man that I could consider to be a role model, that is like more financially successful than me, I get very hyped on becoming more successful myself as well. If I watch a guy that has a better body than me, I get very inspired to want to build a better body as well. There's just something about spending time with other men that inspires you and makes you want to be a man yourself. Number two, improve yourself physically. I've seen this one time and time again. Someone goes to the gym and it's as if something lights up inside of him and he gets into this upward spiral in his life where he just becomes a more positive person and he starts caring more about improving himself on other aspects of his life as well. And I've even seen Jordan Peterson talk about this. I'm not exactly sure where it was. I think it was the Joe Rogan podcast, but he said something like this. He said it probably has something to do with the fact that when you improve yourself physically, you start to observe yourself improving. It's a very concrete thing of improving yourself. And you start to sort of learn that you can actually do something, that you are not a complete loser, but that you can improve some aspect of your life. And so the belief in yourself starts to increase and you also start to like fall in love with this idea of the fact that you can improve yourself. And so you start to translate that love into other aspects of your life as well. You are essentially teaching yourself to love improving yourself. Number three, meditate. Whenever I've meditated, I just feel more aligned with my goals. I feel like it's easier to just want to do what I have to do without distraction. And I think this is probably because of a couple of reasons. The first one is very simple, and that's the fact that a meditation is like a training to your mind. Your mind becomes stronger. Just like how when you go to the gym, your muscles become stronger. And so when you have to lift a heavy object in your daily life, it's easier to lift that heavy object. When you meditate, it's not just about what happens in the meditation itself, but you also become stronger. It becomes easier to be in control of your thoughts and to not have your thoughts control you. Your mind becomes more resilient. And so when you get an urge, when you are on NoFap, you still get that urge. It's not like the urges disappear, but it becomes so much easier to not have that urge control you and to be in control of that urge where you're like, yeah, you know, it's an urge, but so what? Just like how when you're very strong, you're like, well, it's a heavy object, but I don't care. I can lift the heavy object because I'm very strong. If you meditate, that's exactly what it does. It makes your mind stronger, and so it becomes easier to control those urges. Now, I also think that when you meditate, you probably give yourself some time to like think about what you actually want in life, what your goals are, and why you have these goals, and how these goals are actually going to make your life better. And that is probably really going to increase the chance that you view your goals as a positive thing and that you become more likely to like enjoy working towards them. Number four, listen to music. I have often had where I felt weak and I felt tempted to relapse. And then I put on some Viking war drums and it was as if like, bam, my mood snapped and I instantly didn't want to relapse anymore. I was like, yeah, now I want to act like a man and do what is right in life. Now, I'm pretty sure that the type of music that triggers you differs per person. For me personally, the music that really works is like rougher music. So like war drums, heavy metal, hard rock, hard style, you know, like harder types of house music, anything that gets your testosterone pumping. But also the more spiritual music. So like meditation music or certain classical songs, etc. These are the things that really work for me. I'm guessing you're gonna have to like experiment around a bit, see what works for you. But I'm pretty sure that like you should not never underestimate the power of music. It is quite well known that music is very, very effective at influencing us emotionally and just flipping our mood around almost instantly. So that is a very powerful tool. Number five, journaling. In the self-improvement community, journaling is something that has been talked about a lot. And in my opinion, that is for a very good reason, because journaling is such an amazing tool at just aligning yourself with your goals, because it makes you think about your goals all the time. It allows you to reflect on what you have done. It allows you to learn from your mistakes, but it also allows you to like prepare for what you are about to do. So you think about, you know, what am I going to do tomorrow? What am I going to do today? Why am I going to do these things? It kind of forces you to ask the questions, what am I going to do and why do I think that that is a good idea? So you start to think about your goals. You start to think about why you have your goals. You reflect on why you think that working towards your goals is actually going to make your life better. And so the more you do this, as you journal like once or twice a day, you constantly remind yourself of why you want to work towards your goals. And that is just drastically going to increase how positive you become about working towards your goals. Now, if you guys have any more tips to add to this video that I haven't mentioned, do so in the comments below. If you like the video, click the like button, leave a comment below. If you want to see more videos, then click the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.